Hi, my name is Felix. I work at Pessler as Business Development Manager for IIoT and Data Centers. And in this video, I'll show you how to monitor your OT devices with Pessler PITG monitoring software. If you are not yet familiar with PITG, I recommend our other tutorials and webinars, or feel free to contact us. We have been doing monitoring for a long time, and monitoring of IoT is well known. However, the increasing demand for computing power on the factory floor and the respective infrastructure needs to be monitored as well. Due to this development, the boundaries are becoming increasingly blurred. The IoT and OT convergence comes into place. And as I said, I will show you the OT part in PRTG. What we see here is the sensor of an air conditioning system. So we see here different information. These are called channels in PRTG. And the overall status is displayed here and indicated by a green. Also, the gauge's pointer is here on green, so no active error is there. Another possibility is that there is an overload of a fan motor, so that there is a certain type of error. On the right-hand side, we see the sensor type. It's our Modbus TCP custom sensor, what you can find in PRTG. In the lower area, you can see the last values, the minimum values, and also the maximum values of this sensor. Now we come to the OPC UA certificate sensor. With this sensor is kind of similar to the SSL certificate sensor what we have. So for the communication with OPC UA devices in a production or on the factory floor, you have to monitor the certificate of the OPC UA, because the certificate is needed for the communication. If the key is, or if the certificate is expired, then in some cases it's not possible to have the OPC UA communication. So what you can see in this sensor here is the days of expiration, and here the expiration date, or the days are remaining. And of course, the public key length, and also if the certificate is self-signed. On the right-hand side, the sensor, OPC UA certificate, and in the lower area, the respective value as described. This sensor is the OPC UA server status sensor. Again, it indicates everything is green, everything is fine, so the system is working or is functional. And here, the gauge's pointer is on running. Again, here we have other statuses as well, so no configuration, or if the OPC UA server has been suspended, you can also see it in this, or simply it's an error, it's in failure here, and you can see it and can create your alarms here. In this case, the channels, or more information about the OPC UA server status, you can see here. So for example, the session count, they are rejected from the server, or other channels like the sensor count, what you can see here. And again, the sensor type on the right-hand side. Now we go deeper into the shop floor. In this example, we see a more generic sensor. It's called the OPC UA custom sensor. With this custom sensor, you have the possibility to get any information from the OPC UA server. So for example, the speed of the conveyor, you can see here in meters per second, or other information about the shop floor, like the voltages or the counter line. In the upper area, we can create a diagram, for example, in this case, 2 days. And then you can see how the data was in the past, if there was a failure, and what it was, and how to fix this, so that in the future you can prevent these failures, errors. Of course, you have also the possibility to see it in 30 days or 365 days to see this information. Let's go back to the overview. You have also the possibility to use the cogwheel over here, and then if there is an error with the speed, if it's too low or if it's too high, then you can use our alerting tool. The alerting is based on limits, so you can get the alarms via email, SMS, or a Teams notification. Now we come to a vendor-specific sensor, the Beckhoff IPC System Health Sensor. With this sensor, you get the most important information of the Beckhoff IPC. And here you can see the CPU load, the available memory, or for example, the RAID status of the backup IPC. Of course, it's also important for other IPCs. Then you can use the OPC UA, a custom sensor. And in this case, as I said, we have a native sensor with the backup IPC system health. Again, you can analyze it to use the 2 or 30 days diagram to see how the temperature or the CPU load was in the past, and then you can as well create your alarms. It's crucial to see information of the shop floor. In this case, we can get a temperature from an industrial control cabinet. There are a lot of vendors who support different devices for the temperature, to get the temperature from the shop floor. In this example, we use a Rittal IoT interface and the respective sensor of it. So you can get the temperature of your industrial control cabinet, and then again you can analyze the temperature, and maybe it was too high so that you have to install in a fan or just an air conditioning system so that the DCS system is in the right temperature range. We can also use the historic data. So we have the predefined periods of time, 2 days, 30 days, or 365 days, and the historic data. With this historic data, you have the possibility to create reports. So for example, a report over the last 2 days, I can choose it by clicking and then just create the report. And then you can send the report via email or print it out. The MQTT devices in the production floor are increasing. And for this, it's necessary to have an MQTT broker. And for the MQTT broker, we have a so-called MQTT round-trip sensor. So the PRTG MQTT round-trip sensor sends a package to the respective broker and receives the information. So it can calculate the time between sending and receiving. In this case, we have 109 milliseconds for the round trip. And this is a report how the MQTT broker is functioning. With the MQTT statistics sensor, you can get the statistics of a certain topic, or you can see, as in this case, all topics. And this is important to get the information if the broker as well is functioning, or if the respective IoT sensor is working and get your messages. Here we have the MQTT subscribe custom sensor. With this sensor, you can subscribe to a certain topic. This depends then on the respective values from the IoT sensor. For example, in this case, we get the temperature or humidity and pressure from the sensor. And again, you can use the 2 or 30 days to evaluate the sensor. Now you have seen a rather technical view of PRTG and the settings or the alarming of PRTG. In this case, we see a dashboard. In PRTG, it's called Maps. And with Maps, you have the possibility to create your own dashboard for you as a user or for a different user group. And in this particular dashboard, you can see the industry and IT, so the IT-OT convergence. On the left-hand side, you can see the building technology, the diagrams here, or the actual status of the system. In the middle, you can see the IT environment, server, storage system, or also the VMware systems, or just the application area or the application level. You can monitor here and see if everything is working, or if there is a failure or a warning as well. On the right-hand side, you can see key production figures. For example, here from the shop floor or from UPS or an air conditioning system on the right-hand side. As I always say, only creativity is the limit of these dashboards. So you can use the map designer to create custom dashboards, so dashboards that are particular for some users or some user groups, simply by using the map designer, by simply dragging and dropping. On the right-hand side, we see that everything is okay, everything is green and functioning. When we go deeper into that industrial cabinet, we get more information. For example, the DCS system is up and running, the connectivity, or the UPS, as you can see here. If you want to see your MQTT infrastructure, you could imagine such a dashboard. On the left-hand side, you see the different IoT sensors. On the right-hand side, you can see the subscribers and the values of the sensor. In the top, as you can see, the MQTT round-trip sensor to get this information, and of course the MQTT statistics in the LoRa area. So you have everything from the MQTT at a glance. Now we have seen different dashboards in PRTG. But in the end, what's very important is to know what's the state of the whole production and IT. This can be summarized in this dashboard here, with the so-called business process sensor. And with this sensor, you can create a straightforward dashboard in PRTG with just these traffic lights, what you can see here in this area, and without showing the whole complexity of the underlying systems. And you can use this map to display it in a certain point in your company or at the shop floor to visualize the status of your IT and OT. So, there you have it. Now you know how to monitor your OT devices with PRTG. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If so, feel free to leave us a like and consider subscribing. If there's a topic you want us to make a tutorial about, tell us in the comments. If you need help with PRTG, you can contact our support on our website. Have a nice day and thanks for watching.